Hello everyone, my name is Justin Lee Bradley. I am a local artist living in Riverside, California. I'm 25 years old, out of college for about, what's the year? It's 2023? Been out of college for about 3 years now. And I've always kind of wanted to do this where I post videos of how I do things art-wise. Kind of give people a different perspective. There's so many videos out there of people showing how to do art. There's, you know, Ethan Becker, Sam Does Art, Ross Draws, all those guys, all three of them I actually managed to see at Lightbox Expo in Pasadena in 2022. That being said, you know, I just wanted to try and give my take on it and show how I, my process of things, and along the way I myself get better as an artist if people are kind enough to drop advice in the comments, or please don't just drop and say, oh, your art is shit. I understand, okay? I get it. There's some things I'm probably not the best at, but I'm willing to take the criticism, the constructive criticism, to get better. One of the things I'm trying to get better at right now is definitely light and shading. It's always been a difficult thing, and I want to apologize to my professor, Aldo Figueroa, for not taking light and shading as seriously as I should have, because I was so focused on being a storyboard artist. Now I want to do so much more than just be a storyboard artist, but I still want to be a storyboard artist, I want to expand what I can do so I'm able to do more in my field and not just know how to sketch out a nice scene for a film or TV show. But without further ado, I want to start off by showing how I draw faces, specifically at a three-quarter turn, which, you know, people love to draw faces at a three-quarter turn. So how do I start off? Well, I'm using Procreate. It's completely up to date as of late June 2023. And I have specific pencils that I use. I like some of the stuff that Sam Does Art uses, so I picked up some of those. One of my favorite things to use specifically is the peppermint brush from the stock Procreate brushes. And so how do I draw heads? Well, I want to use one of my original characters, as OCs, as the cool kids like to say. And get started. So I have two OCs, a male and a female. I have Arius Bradley. Yes, I gave him my last name. It's kind of like my son at this point. And I have Charlotte Mendoza, who is one I've been focusing on a lot more recently, because I just aesthetically, I like the way the drawings have gone with her, especially some of my recent illustrations when I've been working on light and color. So for the sake of it, because many people are probably more familiar with Charlotte at this point, I'm gonna use Charlotte in a three-quarter head turn. So how I start off a head, there's many different ways you can start off a head. Some people, one of my professors, I remember, taught me to start off a head by doing it like this, because you can get more of a three-dimensional look, and then put the eyes right on the line, nose there, the mouth there, and your chin is going to go here, and then your hairline can go somewhere over here, your eyebrows there, then you have your head right there. That's not really how I do it. How I do it, get rid of that, but I just start with the basic circle. And I use these construction lines to kind of help gauge where I want things, where I want the character to look. So here are various different ways to go about it. So just to kind of show you how that looks, one thing I like to do is I like to put the eyes right on that line or just over it. And kind of find that nose. Right between the mouth. Kind of like that. So what I want to do first, I'm going to keep that, is I'm going to start off with a three-quarter turn. Right about here. Start off with that circle, and then I'm going to have her looking to her right, our left. Slightly up, perhaps. Kind of, what I do here is I kind of get that, kind of get the shape of the head going first. See that there's that jawline there. You got your forehead and your cranium. I'm not very good with the technical terms. And your cranium. I'm not very good with the technical terms. So I just say that the head, or whatever. So you have that. Kind of get more of a look at how you want things to go. So you want this line to kind of divide the head in half. Like that. And then from just behind the ear here, not from up here, I don't put my neck line there. Because that's too much of a tangent line for me. I go more realistic. Because if you look, as I'm looking at the video right now, you see that my neckline doesn't start at my jaw. It starts right back here. So what I want to do is I want to take it. I don't start all the way back here. I actually start just at the earlobe and kind of curve it in. Like that. Then I have my shoulders. I go into my shoulders. That is an eraser. Thing I like to do is get the eyes in there. See, I'm doing it. I'm placing the bottom of the eyes just on this line here. Trying to get them to a point where I want them. I'm kind of placing things in general places right now to kind of get a feel for where I want everything to be. Like right here, the nose. That. Kind of getting the shape of the eyes going now. The eyes. Eyes have always been kind of tricky for me at first, but. There you go. Can you get that look? Have her look. Look up. Now I kind of want to go for more of the shape of the head. Or the cheek bones there. So. I bring the cranium down here to meet her eyebrow and kind of bring it in because the eyes are sitting at a socket. So if you look at me like this, you see that my eye, this part is coming in into a socket where my eye is resting. So I bring this in. Try not to go on a tangent line. Tangent lines, bad. Bad tangent lines. Never do a tangent line. Tangent lines are terrible. Bad, bad tangent lines. We're not doing that.
He's trying to avoid that tangent line by going either just onto the eye and coming back out, or I can bring it around this way. But I think what looks best is that it just goes onto that eye and down. So for Charlotte, the way I draw her is that her cheekbones come out pronounced, and they curve in rather beautifully, like so. And then I curve down into her chin.
Now most female characters that you'll see have a very small chin. I wanted Charlotte to be a little bit different and to make her chin a little bit more square-like, but without making her look too masculine, so I rounded it off to make it look more like a female chin.
And here, bring that jawline there, and we have her ears there. So in there, this is just a rough sketch. If it looks terrible, don't worry, I'll fix it later. I want to start with her hair now. So for her hair, I have these little floofs of hair that kind of curve like that. And then I have more hair that kind of comes around. I have this section of hair. Comes around. And the top of her hair kind of... Oof. Get that back. Ooh, that's not how I want it. Sometimes with Charlotte, what I ended up doing is like giving her a ponytail, but more recently, I've kind of gotten rid of that ponytail for a more, darn it, for a more, you know, flowy hair kind of look. So I see here, let's let her hair just go. Now I'm going to make this bigger. And you probably hear my nephew and my brother-in-law in the background. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to take this sketch, I'm going to drop the opacity to about 25%. I'm going to make a new layer. And then kind of fix up things that went wrong and clean it up real nice. So I'm going to start off here. Usually I'll start off at this point, right between the eyes. Create that nose. Now it's still going to be very sketchy because, you know, nothing's going to be perfect. I like my drawings to be more on the sketchier, rougher side than being it just perfect. I guess that's why I'm starting to fall in love a little more with the painting aspect, because painting, you can be a little bit more sketchy. You can be a little bit more free with how you paint color. And so what I'm going to do here, is I'm just going to create her nose. And I have her mouth just down here. So I want to make sure that everything lines up. So straight down from here, you have her mouth. So there's her mouth. I'm going to get rid of that line so she doesn't look like a cat. I'm going to see what I like about this jawline. Not this jawline, sorry. What I like about the side of her face here. Not like that. I'm actually gonna curve out. What is going on? That's why. My Apple Pencil started freaking out for a second. Curve in that line there. Make her squared off jaw. Bring that in. And one thing I realized is that her face is more elongated. So I want to bring in that jawline. And I can do that on the sketch side of things too. So that way I don't have to mess up the drawing on top. Boom.
Easy peasy, lemon squeezy, haha.
See, I kind of don't stay in one space. Sometimes I'm all over the place. Sometimes I'll jump around and I'm like, okay, that looks nice. Then I'll jump over to the eyeballs and kind of really give that shape to the eyeballs and kind of form how I want those eyes to look. So I got one eye there. And one eye there. So this eye, you're going to see a little bit more of the eyeball. You're going to bring that bottom part of the eye around like that. Kind of formulate. And kind of give her eyeball. The iris and the pupil. All that.
Important thing. Always take time to step back, turn around, look at things. Kind of take some time to get your eyes off the illustration because it will mess you up. If you're constantly looking at it, it'll look great for you for a second. But if you step back, if you step away and you come back, you're gonna look at it and be like, ooh, something was wrong.
So over here, I'm looking at it, and I'm seeing that her right eyeball is a little far off. Or her left eyeball is a little far. So I wanna bring that eyeball in. Looks. I kind of want to bring it down just a little bit too. Get those eyelids going. I'm gonna make this a little bit bigger. There we go. Get a nice feel for that eyeball there. And there we go. The other thing I can do too is I noticed that I want to bring her hair down some. So I'm gonna do just that. Her hair. Bring that down and go back in the main drawing and just like that. And bring the hair tufts around. Bring the hair. Like that. I want to fix her pupils and iris here, so I'm bringing this. I want to fix this one, this eyeball, because it's kind of bugging me. And go back in. Fix it. Cool. So we're gonna bring her lips around like this. And those lips there, we got the bottom portion of the earlobe. I just went full Irish first. And the bottom portion for the earlobe. There we go. I have an earring there. You have this mark that kind of indicates that little change right here. So we have that. See how that looks without all the construction lines and jazz. A We're gonna go this way. Kind of drag the lines. Just kind of clean things up a bit. Clean that up, make that line a little bit more straighter. No, good. Kind of bring that around. Just clean things. Clean things up. Eyelids going. Bring these eyelashes, make these eyelashes a lot fuller. Fill that out. And do I actually want the pupils to look up? Or do I want them to look at the viewer? Kind of want them to look at the viewer. Bring those eyebrows. I want to get those eyebrows erased a little bit to kind of ring in those. Hair tufts. Tufts, whatever they are. Bring those around, clean up those pupils there. Make some cleanup choices. Kind of color in those lips. And then I'm going to go in, darken up that hair. There we go. One thing I'm missing here is proportion. I want to make sure that this is the way it's supposed to be. And I want to bring this hair. Remember what I said about tangerine? No tangerine. Bad, bad tangerine. Nice. Kind of darken that area first, even more. What I'm going to do is I'm going to give it like a dark background. And I'm going to pull what they call an Aaron Blaze. They don't call it an Aaron Blaze, I'm just calling it that. And then make the whites of the eyes. At this point, I'm just using whatever brush to fill in that section. I'm going to probably use line art at this point. Now, Charlotte, where is her thing? Has light blue eyes. So here is where I want to color that in with her light blue eyes. Now what I'm going to do, go up one layer, go to blue, white, and make it a slight blue. Give her some life in those eyes. Maybe make that gray color a little lighter. Fix up those pupils. And that's not what I want. Give her some shading. Eyebrows. Some details. Voila! We have Charlotte.
Well, I hope you liked this video. Please like, comment, give me advice. Subscribe if you really want to. And hope you enjoyed it. Good day.